Hello students, let us try to continue the remaining part of the portion. Morley Minto reforms. The English adopted the policy of divide and rule to create enmity between Hindus and Muslims. Under leadership of Aga Khan, Muslim delegation met Viceroy Minto. Morley was the Indian wazir at that time. And so, the reforms which were prepared after this meeting came to be known as Morley-Minto reforms. So, we are dealing with the freedom movement of India. We already experienced the revolutionary movements within India and outside India. And now a new character enters into the freedom struggle of India. How can we forget our Bapu, Mahatma Gandhi? So let us try to concentrate on the activities which were conducted by Gandhiji to achieve freedom. Arrival of Gandhiji to India, 1915. We know that Gandhiji belonged to Porbandar and he went to England to become a barrister, advocate. From there, he was directly called by one of their relatives, rather we can say neighborhood, with whom they were having good relationship, to fight their case in Africa. A Muslim community person invited Gandhiji to fight his case. And we know the history, and when Gandhiji went to Africa, he saw the miserable condition and he started to fight for their rights of the black people, because the Europeans were believing very firmly that because their skin is white, they are born to rule the entire world. And so they were trying to crush the black people, racism. And Gandhiji gave a very strong fight over there and also became successful. By this success only, when the Indians came to know this from the newspapers, they invited Gandhiji, the Congress leaders, to join this freedom struggle. Gandhiji returned to India in the year 1915 after successfully fighting against racism in South Africa by his weapons of Satyagraha. His political mentor or guru was Gopal Krishna Gokhale, whereas his spiritual guru was Srimad Rajchandra, who was from Morbi, from whom only he got the inspiration. Gandhiji travelled across India to know the problems of people of India and observed the life of Indians. And finally, he came to a conclusion that exploitation was the root of poverty in India, and so he made plans to remove or abolish British rule from India. An important incident took place in the year 1919. Rowlatt Act was passed. Under the chairmanship of Mr. Rowlatt, who was the Minister of Law, the British government formed the Rowlatt Act under his chairmanship in the year 1919. This act was prepared or framed only with one purpose: to suppress the revolutionary movements and nationalism movements in India. And that's why this act came to be known as Black Act, because it was only meant to suppress the individual freedom of the Indians as well as the freedom of speech. According to this act, any suspicious person whom they were suspecting, he could be arrested as well as jailed without conducting any trial against him. That's why only Gandhiji called it as a Black Act. and Motilal Nehru considered it as snatching away of argument, appeal and advocacy right. Under this act, the British government gained immense power to suppress any kind of opposition. People could not raise their voice only, because as soon as they tried to raise their voice, they were jailed. So leaders and people at large expressed their opposition, and for this, meetings were held, rallies were held, processions were taken out, shows took place, and also strikes, no work, were organized against it. Gandhiji was arrested in Delhi. When Dr. Satyapal and Dr. Kichlu were arrested in Punjab, the situation became very severe. And so the government vehemently, strongly tried to suppress all oppositions. And this only gave rise to an incident known as Jallianwala Bagh Massacre. How can we forget this incident? Today also, if you visit that place in Amritsar, we realize what type of agony and pain the people might have had at that time, because they were unweaponed and they had no intention to create any problem to the British government, but still they were killed mercilessly. Jallianwala Bagh Massacre, which took place on 13th of March 1919. When popular leaders of Punjab like Dr. Satyapal and Dr. Kichlu were arrested in Amritsar, Punjab, a public gathering or meeting was organized at Jallianwala Bagh in Amritsar, and the day was fixed as Baisakhi Day to oppose the arrest. General O'Donnell Dyer reached there with his troops and without any warning, opened fire on the innocent people from the machine gun. Now those who have gone to Amritsar and visited the Suvarna Mandir, Golden Temple, very close to it only is Jallianwala Bagh. And you might be surprised to know that this place has only one opening, that also very narrow opening, and there are high walls. So these people were having a meeting over there. They were protesting in a very simple way without any problem. There were high walls on four sides of the bagh, and in the middle was an unused well, and the only way out being narrow, a number of people lost their lives in the firing. According to the government's report, 379 people died and 1200 were injured. As per the committee appointed by the Congress, 1000 people had died in the firing. So, official figure of the Britishers say 379, but actually more than 1,000 people died. Hunter Commission, which was investigating the case on behalf of the British government, defended General Dyer. They said that it was not a mistake. It was done very clear-cut manner. The commission also forgave General Dyer, considering it as an innocent mistake which happened unknowingly. And on the other hand, when this General Dyer returned to England, he was honored with a sword and £2,000. And so Indians got a terrible shock because of this incident. After this inhuman act, Gandhiji's fate towards the British was completely lost. This event only played an important role in uniting the whole nation. This tragedy became the ground for the future non-cooperation movement also. Student, please try to underline these points, because it is asked as a short note manual. The next important event which took place in the time of Gandhiji, Khilafat movement. During the First World War, we saw that Turkey had joined the German side. It was helping Germany. So when England won, that is the Allies, The treaty that was made had many firm and unjust terms as well as conditions for the losing side. The Sultan of Turkey, please underline, at that time was a Khalifa, head of Muslims. The movement in India to oppose the strict terms imposed on Turkey and the Sultan only came to be known as Khilafat movement. Popularly known as Ali brothers, that is Maulana Shaukat Ali and Maulana Muhammad Ali, were the chief leaders of the movement. Gandhiji requested even Congress to support the movement, keeping Hindu-Muslim unity in mind. And so the movement became very severe with the Congress support. Non-cooperation movement, which took place in the year 1920-22, and then it had to be suspended. The Nagpur Conference of the Indian National Congress gave the approval to the non-cooperation movement December 1920. So now the Congress made a strong demand for independence of India, that is Swaraj, instead of self-government or Swashasan under the rule of British Empire. This non-cooperation movement had some constructive effects also, as well as negative effects also. Constructive effects. In the positive aspect of the movement was Hindu-Muslim unity to be strengthened, please underline. Insistence on using the Swadeshi articles to use only Indian goods. Revival of the spinning wheels, charkha, in every house to view the cloth and not to buy the foreign cloth. Collection of 1 crore rupee for the Tilak Swaraj Fund also was taken in this non-cooperation movement only. And to abolish untouchability, to spread national education, and prohibition of the liquor was also activity done in this movement. So these are the constructive aspects or effects of the non-cooperation movement. Negative effects. It consisted of giving up the government jobs. People started to leave up government jobs. The students left the government schools and colleges. There was boycott of the legislatures. The judges, the people who were working in the government courts started to resign from their jobs. From the local self-government bodies also they started to resign. All over India, people boycotted foreign cloth and other articles. They also did not attend any government functions. They also gave back their titles, etc. Now, what type of program was prepared for non-cooperation movement? In the beginning of the movement, Mahatma Gandhi and Rabindranath Tagore surrendered their titles Kaisar e Hind and Knighthood Honor respectively. Please underline. Mahatma Gandhi was given the title of Kaisar e Hind and Rabindranath Tagore was given the title of Knighthood Honor. Other leaders of the nation also gave their titles and positions. Students started to leave English schools and colleges. At various places, foreign clothes were set on fire. When Duke of Kainat came to India, he was boycotted. No one attended his any functions in the year 1921, November. Also, the ceremony to honor Prince of Wales was boycotted. Such incidents created considerable national excitement. On the other side, Indian schools, national schools and colleges were established, like Kashi Vidyapeeth, Bihar Vidyapeeth, Jamia Millia Vidyapeeth, Gujarat Vidyapeeth, etc. Due to the vigorous propaganda for Swadeshi goods, now the import of the foreign cloth, the footwear, the luxurious items from England reduced drastically. This reaction rattled the British Parliament. They were shocked. The government was shocked by this kind of huge economic loss to England. Just imagine that more than 1 crore rupee at that time was collected in the Tilak Fund. On many occasions, the Hindu-Muslim emerged predominantly. The Mopla revolt, which took place in the Malabar area between Hindu landlords and the Muslim farmers, deserves criticism and it was suppressed by the British Army. Page number 29. The government adopted the policy of suppression. For this, uncontrolled lathi charge, firing, collective arrest and inhuman torture was meted out. Unsuccessful attempts were carried out to break Hindu-Muslim unity. It is the incident of Chauri Chaura which disturbed Gandhiji a lot, and he had to withdraw this movement. In Uttar Pradesh, a village very close to Gorakhpur district is Chauri Chaura. In this village, people took out a rally supporting the non-cooperation movement. The police opened the fire on the people, but when all their bullets were over, they ran short of the bullets. They immediately went to the police station, locked, and thought that they are safe now. People attacked this police station and set on fire, in which 21 policemen were burnt alive. On receiving this horrible news, Gandhiji said, "I have committed a Himalayan blunder by giving the tool of satyagraha in the hands of the people who do not understand the value of non-violence." And so he suspended this movement immediately. What was the importance of this movement and what were the effects? Let us try to summarize it. This movement did not achieve the desired aims, but by the negative and constructive aspects, it managed to generate in people the awareness of their rights. People became aware that they must fight for their rights. And so now a negative atmosphere against the British government was created. People felt a strong feeling of opposition against injustice. There was also a political awareness created among all the classes of India. Now the faith for independence became stronger. The people forgot or had no fear of any punishment, or rather imprisonment or lathi charge. It was removed completely. The youth and the women came forward to serve their nation, and so the Congress became an organization of the people. Schools giving national education started. Hindi language started getting more and more importance than English. The movement, which was limited to cities and towns and intellectuals, now spread in nook and corner of India, that is also in villages. Swaraj Party. With the purpose to retain the national awareness among the people, Chittaranjan Das Munshi and Motilal Nehru formed the Swaraj Party after the withdrawal of the non-cooperation movement. Please underline, their purpose was to enter the legislative assemblies and oppose the unfair policies of the government. So they asked permission of Gandhiji that we want to fight the elections, we want to enter into the government and then oppose their policies. The leaders of the Swaraj Party also adopted the constructive activities of Gandhiji, like abolition of untouchability, Hindu-Muslim unity, revival of the spinning wheel, liquor prohibition, etc. Gandhiji gave the permission, and so Swaraj Party contested the elections of the legislatures, which took place in the year 1923, November. And the result was very successful. The candidates of the Swaraj Party were elected in the central legislature as well as the provincial legislature and got a clear majority. It only did not get majority in Bengal, but still it emerged as a strong party. Motilal Nehru was elected into the central legislature as the party leader, and Chittaranjan Das was elected in the Bengal province. What step did the
Swaraj Party take out. Underline, Swaraj Party disapproved the government budgets and proposals and resented the unjust policies of the government. Underline, it also compelled the government to consider the problems of the people. Due to the working of the Swaraj Party only, the government had to appoint the Simon Commission 2 years earlier. We know that Simon Commission was appointed to see the welfare activities of India. And this was appointed 2 years earlier. Underline, the Swaraj Party functioned in a disciplined manner and established high parliamentary practices. It proved to the British government that Indians can rule constitutionally as well as democratically. The educated class of India was thus attracted to the Swaraj Party. National awareness re-emerged in the people. The Swaraj Party played a crucial role to bring the achievement of independence very close and near. All this indicates the importance of the party. But with the death of Chittaranjan Das in June 1925, this party became very weak. Some members began supporting the government, while others established a new party named the National Party. Thus, the prestige of the Swaraj Party reduced. In the 1926 election, all its members lost terribly, except in the Madras province. Bipin Chandra Pal and Surinath Banerjee even criticized the party strongly. So these were the moments from 1857 to 1925. I hope you might have underlined, and so it will become very easy for you to answer all the questions. Please try to complete your workbook.